Hi everyone. I just wanted to do a quick where am I Wednesday today because once again I was sort of in transit for most of the day. Didn't have a big adventure. And I just wanted to talk about hostels for a minute. As most of you may know, I do a lot of my traveling by house sitting. So in that case, I don't actually get paid to do the house sit, but I also don't have to pay for a place to stay, which is great, especially when you're trying to travel long term like I am. And so I think I left Canada in August, and it wasn't up until maybe October some point where I actually ended up having to pay for a place to stay, and that was in Istanbul. It was partially because I was in between sits. I had booked one in near Bodrum, Turkey, and then the next one I actually had booked in Vietnam. So I had a couple weeks in between, and I chose to stay in Istanbul for a bit, where I booked a couple different hostels, and then I ended up in Bangkok, where I booked a couple as well. And so one tip, which I'm not sure if I've mentioned before during traveling, is that I never actually book a hostel for more than a night or two in advance, because you never really know what you're gonna get, and they can suck. But the thing is, in a lot of towns, there's usually more than one, and it's pretty easy to book one the day of or the night of. And in this case right now, I'm in Chiang Mai, Thailand, and I booked one the night that I got here, and it turned out to be quite noisy. It was a lovely place, but it was right across the street from a bar, and it was also on a really busy street. And just to give you an idea of what kind of cost is, it cost me about $12, $13 Canadian, which really isn't too bad. No, I can get far cheaper options. In fact, I spent $4 or $5 for a night in one place here, and that was terrible. If I can, I'll include a picture of the bathroom to give you an idea of why it was $4 or $5 a night. But because of the noise last night, I didn't bother to book that hostel again, and I actually just moved down the street and booked another one, which is where I am right now, and I actually got basically a private single room for $12 with air conditioning and a little desk, and I decided that I'm going to spend the rest of the time that I have to here because I started house sit on Saturday and it's Wednesday, obviously. So I'll be here for the rest of the week, and that's kind of my update. I just wanted to give you an idea of how it is that I travel cheaply, and one of those things would be that obviously I do as many house sits as I can. I've been lucky enough to get three here in Chiang Mai now in the next few weeks. And before that, I'm going to be doing the hostel thing. And like I said, I'm spending about $12 a night for this place. And that's it. I'm going to post this video, and then I'm going to go out and get some food, which again is another cheap option in a place like Chiang Mai, Thailand. So, as always, thanks for watching. Hope you're having a good evening, a good afternoon, or a good night, and a good morning wherever you are. And I'll talk to you next week.